Hello everyone, welcome back to AK SAS class once again. Hope last video lesson was useful for you all. In this video we will learn a new lesson. Well, everyone get ready for the lesson. Keep your book and pen ready. Make a silent prayer. Let's begin. Standard 5, EVS 2, Chapter 1, What is History? In the last class, we studied about what is history, the definition, the different words used to show present time, past time and future time, the division of time into past, present, future and etc. etc. And that was our video number 1. Now this is our video number 2 of chapter 1, and now we'll study here a lot more about history, the scientific method of history. The speciality of all the sciences that we studied in standard 3rd and 4th is that their facts or evidences can be tested in experiments which can be repeated anytime, anywhere. Okay, in standard 3rd and 4th you study different sciences, but there is one speciality of all those sciences is that facts or the evidences can be tested in experiments in laboratory, okay, and can be repeated at any time and anywhere. The method of using a number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable or not is called scientific method. So you will be getting a question, that is, what is scientific method? So then you have to answer it. The method of using a number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable or not is called scientific method. History uses scientific method at every stage. Okay, the same like other sciences, history also uses science at every stage while looking for evidence. So history at the first rate looking for evidence, while collecting evidence, while examining the evidence, while putting the evidences together. At all these different stages, history uses scientific method. Okay, while looking for evidence, while collecting evidence, while examining the evidence, and while putting the evidences together, history uses scientific method at every stage. Scientific discipline. History, when required, help is taken from other sciences. That is why history is considered to be a scientific discipline. Okay, you may also get a question, that is, why is history called a scientific discipline? So then you understand, history when required, okay, help is taken from other sciences. Okay, that is why history is considered to be a scientific discipline. So in any stage of its collection of evidences, okay, if history take the help of other sciences, okay, that is why we call history a scientific discipline. History, when required, help is taken from other sciences. Okay, that is why history is considered to be a scientific discipline. History is not written solely on the basis of imagination. So don't think that the historians just imagined and then written history. It's not like that. History is not solely written on the basis of imagination. Okay, it has done lot of studies. The science help is taken from others. Scientific help is taken from other sciences. And after making proper analytics studies, then only history is written. So don't think that it is written solely on the basis of imaginations. Let's study about the sources of history. You can see in these different pictures, the first one you can see a sculpture, you can see a structure, world famous structure, one of the seven wonders of the world, Taj Mahal. You can see the coins, collection of coins. You can see another structure, historical monument, you can see Qutub Minar. Okay, again you can see a number of different type of ports, a collection of books, library of books. You can see copper plates. So these are all different source of history. Source of history, you can see sculpture, old structures, collection of coins, pots, books, copper plates, etc. Ancient objects, structures, sculptures, pots, coins, inscriptions, copper plates, books, manuscripts, traditional stories, and songs remembered over many generations, etc., are the sources of history. So, what are the sources of history? Ancient objects, structures, sculptures, pots, coins, inscriptions, copper plates, books, manuscripts, traditional stories, and songs remembered over many generations, etc., are the sources of history. So, when you get a question, what are the sources of history, or list the sources of history, you have to write all these words. Manuscripts, so handwritten and not published ones. So they are called manuscripts. Lot of books are collected. Copper plates, all this include in the sources of history. Sources of history are of three types. The sources of history are classified into three different categories: material sources, written sources, and oral sources. Sources of history divided into three categories. There are of main three categories. They are material sources, written sources, and oral sources. With the help of tested evidences, past events are put in a proper sequence and a historical account is written. Okay. With the help of tested evidences, past events are put in a proper sequence and a historical account is written. This is scientific method. So, scientific method, you must understand now what you exactly mean by that. So, in scientific method, with the help of the tested evidences, whatever the evidence are collected and tested, all the past events are put together in a proper order, in a proper sequence, and a historical account is written. Okay, and that is the scientific method of history. Okay, now for the revision part, you do the following, then the lesson will be clear for you. History is not written solely on the basis of dash. I already referred it earlier. History is not written solely on the basis of imagination is the word you have to fill in the blanks over there. Just find out from back from our explanation again, then you do this exercise. What is scientific method? Next question. Why is history considered to be a scientific discipline? Okay, what first? Second question is, what is scientific method? And the third one is, why is history considered to be a scientific discipline? Fourth one, what are the three types of sources of history? You remember what are three types? I said you, material sources, written sources, and oral sources. Just revise again and see that for yourself once again. Then you write down. What are the three types of sources of history? And the last one, list the different sources of history. List the different sources of history. That also you have seen after showing all the pictures. On the last part, I have shown you I explained you what are the different sources. You have seen that ancient objects, structures, sculptures, pots, coins, inscriptions, copper plates, books, manuscripts, traditional stories, and songs remembered over many generations are the sources of history. So this part you have to write down. So I hope this small lesson is clear for you. You may go on revising it once again, see the video once again, and all the main points what I discussed, revise again and do this exercise, so the lesson will be clear for you. Okay everyone, hope today's lesson is clear to you all. Watch the video again and do the given activities. Okay, have a nice day.